Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Welcome to Bank Millennium Conference after first quarter 2019. Management board of the bank is represented today by Chief Executive Officer, Mr. João Brás Jorge. We have Chief Financial Officer, Deputy Chairman, Mr. Fernando Bicho. Also Chief Economist, Grzegorz Maliszewski. My name is Artur Kulesza. I am Chief of IR. As always, we start with short presentation, then followed by Q&A. I give the floor to Chief Financial Officer, Mr. Fernando Bicho.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Thank you for coming today, and thank you for attending this conference through webcast. We will go through the presentation of the first quarter results. We can go directly to the page number six of the presentation. We should start by saying that we had a good beginning of the year, especially in terms of the business results. Also we managed to show a better first quarter result than one year ago for the reasons that I will explain later. We reached a net profit of 160 million zlotys, which is 3% above one year ago, with an adjusted ROE, adjusted by extraordinary items and also regularly accruing the contributions to the Banking Guarantee Fund. This ROE adjusted at 9.1%, still influenced by the significant growth of equity versus one year ago of almost 10%. Cost to income at 46.1% is lower than the ratio for the full year 2018. In the first quarter, we had a very strong growth of net interest income by 14.6% year-on-year. It was flat on a quarterly basis, but mainly due to shorter quarter. Net commission income reverted the downward trend and grew by 1% versus the fourth quarter of 2018, although still showing a drop of over 5% versus one year ago due to the negative evolution of the investment products during the last year. Operating costs still grew by 9%, excluding BFG contributions that were booked in the first quarter. We kept a high level of asset quality with an impaired or loan ratio, Stage 3 ratio at 4.4%, with a relatively high level of coverage of total impaired loans by provisions at 73%. The cost of risk stood exactly in the middle of the range that usually we are showing as a guidance at 55 basis points over total net loans on an annualized basis. The loan-to-deposit ratio at very low, 81%, with the bank fully prepared in terms of liquidity position for the acquisition of Eurobank. On the capital side, we strengthened the capital ratios during the first quarter due to the decision of general shareholders meeting of the bank of retaining the full net profit of 2018 in the own funds of the bank. Second, by the issuance of 830 million zlotys of subordinated bonds on the 30th of January, which in the meantime were already approved by KNF to be included in Tier 2 capital of the bank. As a consequence of these two main factors, we reached a total capital ratio of 25.6% and a Tier 1 ratio of 21.5% in the end of March. Finally, we had also an upgrade of the rating of the bank by Moody's to the level of Baa1. Moving to page number seven. I already mentioned the growth of the net profit by 3% year-on-year. We have to take into account specific events of the first quarter that justify the evolution of the result. Of course, on one side, on the negative side, we had the significant increase of the contributions to the resolution fund, which almost doubled versus one year ago, slightly partially offset by a small decrease in the contributions to the deposits guarantee fund. As a consequence, we during the first quarter had higher contributions to the banking guarantee fund by close to 30 million zlotys. So this was the negative. On the other side, we had the positive extraordinary impact of a recovery of a tax asset, which had been provisioned several years ago, and which finally was recovered, which has a positive impact on the P&L of the quarter by around 24 million zlotys. So these two events did not fully offset, but to a large extent offset each other. But and as a consequence of the operational improvement, we were able to show an improvement in the net profit of the quarter by 3% year on year. Operating income grew 13%, but especially we would highlight the solid growth of core income by almost 9% versus the first quarter of last year, strongly supported by the growth of net interest income. Operating costs in the recent past have been growing at a little bit faster pace than what we used to show. In this case, 9% growth versus the first quarter of last year, excluding BFG contributions, 16% if everything is included, with similar growth of personal costs and other admin and depreciation. The cost-to-income ratio at around 46%, very similar to the levels coming from the previous year. Moving to page number 8, now in providing some more explanations regarding the evolution of the main items, and starting with net interest income. We had, as I said, first of all, a very good increase of net interest income year on year, 14.6%. The net interest income was almost flat versus the previous quarter. We had on one side less 2 days versus the previous quarter. Second, we had a small increase in the average cost of deposits, as shown on the right-hand side graph. It's to a large extent attributable to the fact that we had a significant increase of the deposits in the fourth quarter of 2018, also as a consequence of some promotional campaigns, still some this spilled over in terms of the cost to the first quarter of this year. Although I can say that the trend is again positive, and we would expect in future quarters to again reduce the average cost of the deposit base. The second factor is also that we issued subordinated debt in the end of January, so we have already reflected in the overall cost of funding, not in the deposits, but in the overall cost of funding, the additional cost of the subordinated debt, which in fact is responsible for a contraction of 4 basis points of the NIM during the first quarter versus the fourth quarter. We also have a very small impact of implementation of IFRS 16, which is to a small extent reflected in net interest income. This, I would say, would represent 1 basis point contraction of NIM just due to this IFRS 16 implementation standard. Finally, we also have to take into consideration that we have been preparing for the transaction of Eurobank. And as a consequence, in terms of the liquidity management, of course, we have been preparing the liquidity that is necessary for the payment of the price and for the repayment of the funding of Eurobank to Société Générale, which translates into having a shorter tenor of the investments of the bond portfolio, which of course have a lower yield. So putting everything together, we have this, let's say, paradox of on one side a very solid growth of net interest income versus 1 year ago, while at the same time having a contraction of the NIM in the quarter, which, as I said, we expect to reverse in future quarters. In terms of net commission income, the good news is that we saw signs of improvement already in the investment funds commissions. And so, of course, this does not offset the fall that we experienced last year. And so year on year, total commissions are still falling 5%. But as I said, we see some positive signs in terms of flows to investment funds, and as a consequence on the fees that that we get from these funds, which if continued should allow us through time to smooth this year-on-year comparison and to ultimately to come back to a growth of fee and commission income. On page 9, the asset quality remains solid, even the overall stage 3 loan ratio improved to 4.4%, although partially due to the write-offs that we have done during the quarter. The cost of risk was higher than 1 year ago, 55 basis points over total net loans, 72 million zlotys. I should first of all remind that last year we had exceptionally low level of cost of risk, so we were open about it. We said that it was exceptionally low, and we would not expect that it would be repeated this year. And in fact, we are back to the range of 50 to 60 basis points, in this case 55 during this first quarter. We don't see, we cannot say that it is this, let's say, a deterioration of the quality of the loan portfolio. There are always episodically exposures that need to be additionally provisioned, and which translated into this cost of risk of 55 basis points in the quarter. Liquidity I already mentioned, very, very strong indicators, and capital ratios also stronger in advance for the transaction of Eurobank. So, moving now to the second part of the presentation on page 11, and just starting with a brief update about where we are in terms of the process of acquisition of Eurobank. We are still targeting the closing of the transaction in the second quarter, so by more concretely in the end of May, of course subject to having the necessary regulatory approvals. So if this would be, if this will be achieved, this would allow us to do the legal merger of the two banks by the end of the third quarter, and to be able to do the operational merger still before the end of the year, which would be, which basically would still was the plan that we have presented in November when we announced the transaction. So for the time being, we are sticking to these targets. Of course, not everything depends on us, but we are doing everything in order to be able to achieve this this plan. On the but having said that, we are not neglecting the other part of the plan, which is the execution of the organic growth strategy, which is translated into very strong numbers that are shown here on page 11. On the retail side, a very strong pace of customer acquisition, which continues from the previous year, and which translates into a net growth of 222,000 customers active in retail. The quarter was also marked by record high sales of cash loans, 988 million zlotys, which represent a growth of 29% year on year, and also very strong sales of new mortgage loans, 856 million zlotys, a growth of 14% year on year. Deposits grew 11% year-on-year in retail, of course more flattish versus the previous quarter after an extraordinary strong growth in the fourth quarter. We almost reached 1.5 million digital customers from retail, a growth of 22% year-on-year. On the corporate side, we keep the same trends, double-digit growth of overall lending, 14.9% year on year, also followed by the same pace of growth of deposits. And in terms of quality and innovations, we continue to be regularly rewarded with different distinctions and awards from different entities, especially in terms of quality of service, social sensitive bank. But this is consistent with the trends that are coming from previous periods. Moving now to page 12, and regarding the growth of the loan portfolio, excluding FX mortgage, total loans grew by 17.8% year on year. And this keeps the trend that is coming from the previous years, with especially strong growth of mortgage and also of consumer loans. The structure of the loan portfolio continues to change, with a higher share of PLN mortgages and other retail loans. And on the deposit side, very solid growth year on year of total deposits, 11% in retail, 15% in corporate, and also in the lower part of the page, the illustration of what I already mentioned, this rebound in investment products with a growth of 4% versus the previous quarter, although still falling 8% versus the previous year. On page 13, we show more details about the retail business development, with the continuation of the solid growth of current accounts and savings accounts deposits, with a growth of 16% year on year, with a more modest growth of term deposits. And the consistent pace of customer acquisition, with 59,000 net growth of active customers in retail just in the first quarter of the year. And this growth is to a large extent supported by the increased number of current accounts, which grew by more than 300,000 year on year, and also followed by also more than 358,000 growth in the number of total cards, with market share in credit card transactions above 8%. On page 14, the overall growth in retail is strongly supported by the growth of digital channels. We think these numbers are impressive. We are showing a growth of 22% of active digital customers to almost 1.5 million, and a growth of mobile customers active by 40% year on year, already crossing the threshold of 1 million. This is, apart from supporting the overall servicing of these customers, is also becoming a relevant support of sales, illustrated by this very high share of the number of cash loans that were sold through digital channels, which stood at 48% in the first quarter of this year, comparing with 37% last year. In time deposits, the picture did not change. It is already happening like this for several years. But also digital channels are becoming relevant for current account acquisition, representing already a 25% share in the first quarter. The mobile channel importance is also illustrated on page 15 with several other indicators, such as the explosive growth of number of BLIK transactions or HE cards portfolio and mobile top-ups, which also shows how regularly used are our mobile applications. And also for this, of course, we are continuing the regular process of releasing innovations and developments of our e-banking applications, which is illustrated on page 16, which is, of course, let's say, generating this regular use of our mobile application. And also the same is shown in page 17, with the increased downloads of our Goodie applications, our smart shopping platform, which already crossed 1.1 million downloads since the start, and specifically 200,000 just in the first quarter of 2019. On page 18, retail lending evolution was very positive during the first quarter due to this significant growth of sales of cash loans, which, as I repeat, grew by 29% year on year, reaching 988 million zlotys. So we went to another level. Is the consequence of many years of improvements that were done on this area, and bringing the overall growth of consumer loans year on year to 17.5%. Mortgage loans also a very good quarter, especially when compared with 1 year ago, 14% growth, 856 million origination, generating a growth of the portfolio by 20% year on year. Moving to the corporate side, deposits grew 15% year on year, but especially current account deposits grew 16%, also showing higher transactionality of our customer base, while loans, total loans grew 14% on a gross base, 14.7% on a net basis, with specifically a growth of 17% in loans, 12% in leasing, and 9% in factoring. So this is basically keeping trends that are already coming from previous quarters. And the sales of leasing and factoring, as shown on page 20, are also supporting this growth. This time, the growth is not double-digit, it's around 7% year on year, but still very supportive for the overall growth of the corporate business. These are the main highlights of our first quarter results, so now we will be available for questions. Thank you.